That's you.
Yeah, I had it.
It's approaching 11 o'clock.
It's a long day, my friend. Well,
that was great.
My name is Adolfo Pichardo. I'm actually a minister from the Assemblies of God. I'm actually the youngest minister in New England, so it's definitely an honor and a pleasure to be here. I take a look at you guys' faces. I know you've been here for a long time. Trust me, I was sitting in the back at 5 o'clock. I seen all the expressions from frustration to happiness to laughs, and it's definitely a pleasure, and I thank you for this opportunity to be here. All right. The main reason why we're here is because of marriage. You know, you hear a lot of things about God, you hear a lot of things about religion, and there's some things that you don't hear about marriage at all. You know, one argument that I hear consistently is gays should not be married because they don't have the ability to reproduce. But there are also heterosexuals that do not have the ability to reproduce, so should they not get married? You know, when I think about marriage, yes, I do think about children. I do think about love. I do think about purpose. Purpose is what I think about when I think about marriage. I think about reverence. You know, reverence is such a strong word. If President Obama was to walk into this room right now, you would feel his presence. Because his presence will not only, you know, not only would you sense it, but it would give him some sort of validation. And that's what so many people are looking for, as validation. I personally am against, you know, the Bill 38. You know, I believe marriage is between one woman and one man. But there's so many people who are here because they want that validation of marriage. You know, it is within their right, and yes, they do have the right to argue that. You know, it's a difficult situation that you guys are in because there's benefits involved. You know, there's recognition that's involved, there's validation that's involved, and it's so hard. It's not an easy decision at all. But we have to understand that marriage is there love in marriage? Yes. You know, I heard one quote that was said that marriage is not between a man and a woman, marriage is between love and love. But what is love? What could you define as love? You know, when I think of God, I think of his infinite mercy, his infinite grace, his infinite forgiveness. I also think about his infinite love. His love has no void. When you read the Bible, his love has no void. But me, being raised by a single mother, there was a void. You know, because when I think about it, there was certain characteristics that were missing. Because my mother, she could teach me how to be a great person of character. But yes, she could never teach me how to be a man because she did not know what a man is, for she is not a man, you know. So there was always that void there. Senator Archibald mentioned it a few hours earlier. He said, well, you would look for that. You know, you would look amongst your peers. You were looking for amongst your friends. You would look at, you know, amongst your neighbors. But yet, that void was there in the first place. Why? Because there was not a father around. You know, and the thing is about gay marriage is, do I believe two people could love each other? Yes, but it promotes that void, that reverence, that change of atmosphere. Love costs something. Love is not free. It there's a cost to love, and then if you change this law, if you pass that bill, then the atmosphere will change. The reverence will change because there is new recognition now. And that's the thing that we have to understand. If we pass this, it's going to cost something. Whether it's good, whether it's bad, it's up to your opinion. You know, everyone has the free opinion, but we do have to understand that it's going to cost something, you know. And that's what it comes down to. You know, I definitely thank you for hearing me. I had so many things that I wanted to say, but waiting for 6 hours is not easy, and your mind just goes blind, you know. In the moment, your voice gets dry. But I definitely want to thank you for those who vote against it. Yes, I am with you. And for those who are with it, I still do respect you, you know, because it's not easy. And I could definitely understand. My sister's lesbian and she's married, you know, and I love her to death, you know. And it's not an easy decision for me to be up here and say, you know what, Jasmine, even though I love you, I'm not for this bill. It's not easy, you know. But I commend you for the decision that you're going to make, whether I agree with you or not. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Pichardo.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for waiting.
You're welcome.
Any questions for the witness?